Wow, he's really tall, actually. What's going on, guys?
George,
on a trip.
What's going on?
All right. Shall we? So, I conducted a survey the other day. Well, it really wasn't a survey, I guess. I just got really drunk and texted the same question to every girl in my phone book. Yeah, don't do that. I texted them, "Hey, what's up? What are you doing? Wanna come over and sit on my face?" And boy, are people rude. Like, you should have seen some of the responses I got. It was unbelievable. So I'm single, apparently. Currently, too. And I've been dating a lot, though. And why is that funny, sir? So I've been dating, and I went on a date a couple weeks ago, and it went really well, I thought, you know? Like, I was laughing at her jokes, she was laughing at my jokes. And then, like, halfway through, I realized I wasn't her type, because she started talking about her ex-boyfriend, and she was like, "Yeah, my ex-boyfriend drives a limited edition Jaguar." And I was like, I live with my mom, and my mom is with her mom. I wish that was a joke. It's I do live with my grandma. She's she just turned 96 years old a couple months ago.
Yeah!
Strong woman. Apparently not that strong, though, because we had a surprise party for her. And after the surprise, we had to rush her to the hospital. It's not funny. She didn't have a heart attack or anything. She just couldn't withstand my 96 birthday punches to the face. I'm kidding. They're more like birthday kicks, because after the first punch, that bitch just dropped. I'm joking. I'm gonna rid my grandma on her birthday. That's rude. But I went so as I said before, I was dating a lot, and I went on a date with this chick who had a baby. She had a kid, which was cool, like, I didn't mind. But I didn't know she was gonna bring her baby with her on the date. And I'm a nice person, I really didn't mind at all, but she has the ugliest fucking baby that you've ever seen in your life. And we went to the movies in the mall. So we're walking around the mall, and like people are like thinking that, you know, we're together and this is our baby. People would like walk by and like, and like I felt obligated to like stop them. Like every person was like, "Hey, listen, this is not my kid. Don't think that. It's not my baby. Look at this face and look at that face. There's no way he came out of my dick." And another thing, like, I don't know if you guys have ever been to a movie with a baby. It should be against the law. Like, honestly, this is like an infant, and all babies do two things: shit, and then cry about it. And I'm pretty sure, like, you're not supposed to take a shit and cry during a movie in a movie theater. It's just really rude. I don't know, it's my opinion. It was disturbing. So I was an altar boy when I was little. And, like, nobody got molested or anything in my parish. Like, I didn't hear any stories like that. But then after all these, like, stories started coming out in the news, and you hear about, like, kids getting molested, like, I started thinking back, like, when I was a little kid, and I was an older boy. And, like, now that I think about it, like, creepy things did happen, but, like, I didn't realize it was creepy at the time, because I was so young. And, like, for instance, like, one Sunday before Mass, I remember, like, the priest came up and he was like,
Michael, could you light the candles for me, Michael?
And I was like, "Yeah, sure, Father." Apparently I sounded like a little faggot when I was little. So, like, I went and, like, started lighting the candles and he was like,
"No, Michael, not that candle, Michael. Light the one behind it."
And I'm like, "Okay." So I'm, like, reaching behind, like, trying to light it. He's like,
No, Michael. The one above, that one in the back, Michael."
And I was like, "Okay, sure, Father, this is really hard." And he's like,
"It It is hard, Michael, isn't it? It's very hot too, Michael. Oh, it's so hot. Do it for Jesus, Michael.
I don't know. I thought that was kind of creepy. Right? I don't know. So, I don't have, like, a specific type of girls that I go after. But I do prefer, like, small petite girls. Not because I think, like, I'm attracted to them more than any other girl, but because they really make my penis look a lot bigger than it really is. You know? Like, I'll be fucking them, I'm like, yeah, you want that monster dick? You want that monster dick? And they're like, Mike, it's really not that big. Seriously. Alright, guys, that's all I got. Thank you so much. That was awesome.
Let's put it up one more time for Mike Goodsey.